We're having fun. Hopefully you are having fun. If you're not having fun, order the wine. The red wine is really good. Because more you drink. No, I'm just kidding. So that was Hackensack. This next tune is, actually, before I do that, does anyone, if anyone can guess this or get the closest to this answer, I'll get a free t-shirt. I think the t-shirts are cool. Monk wrote 50, 60, or 70 songs. Does anyone care to guess? 50? 50 going once? 70. She gets the t-shirt. 70. That's a lot for any composer, but for a jazz composer, that's a lot. And the thing about Monk is he's a true jazz composer. Like a lot of the standard repertoire that we use, it was written for Broadway shows. So Monk actually, sometimes he used those song forms and wrote his own melodies, but a lot of times he came up with his own chord changes and melody at the same time. So Monk is definitely at the high. High on the list as far as writers are concerned. So this next song, Rhythmining, is his most recorded song. And we kind of deconstructed this tune, and it's a lot of fun to play, and I hope you enjoy it. This is Rhythmining. Thank you. Thank you. That was rhythmic. This next tune has a bit of an interesting story. I was here some years ago, and I was playing with this wonderful jazz singer, John Hendricks. He's one of the forefathers of jazz vocals, and he was a good friend of Thelonious Monk. And he was 76 at the time, I think, when we were playing here. And the interesting thing about John is that, you see we're having fun. When John was on the stage, he was only supposed to sing two songs, but it was difficult to get him off the stage after those two songs. He was just like, no, man, this is fun. We got to do this. He was like, John, you have to go. We have to finish the set, you know? He just loved playing just like we do. And so I told him we're doing this. I was going to do a Monk album or a Monk tribute kind of record. And he told me, he says, listen here, young blood. And I like to be called a young blood at the time because I was kind of old. No, I'm just kidding. He says, if you're going to do a Monk project, you should make sure that it's going to be different. It has to be different because Monk was a different kind of cat. And for those of you who don't know what a cat is, we're cats. He was a different kind of person. He was an interesting kind of person. And he said, make sure that it's different, because if Monk was alive, he would want to hear his songs played in a different way. He wouldn't want to hear his songs played the way he wrote them in the 60s. It was a long time ago. So I went home, and I thought about this song, but I didn't know the history behind this song. So this song came about because there was a famous pianist, Bud Powell. It was amazing. He was 7 years younger than Monk, and just, you know, they were best friends, both of them amazing pianists. And they were in a club one day, and one night, and the police burst in and to stop the jazz music, and they immediately arrested Thelonious because he was playing. And they had him in handcuffs, and they were about to escort him out the door, and Bud Powell stood up, and he blocked the door. And he was like, stop, what are you doing? This guy, do you know who this is? And the police didn't care, but he says, well, you know, this is Thelonious Monk. He's one of the world's greatest jazz pianists. And the police response was to club Bud Powell in the head with a baton. And incidentally, or after that, Bud Powell had many, many headaches. He had to be committed to hospital, like just all the time, and Monk felt that he felt like he was responsible for that. So he wrote this song, along with two other songs, just to be gifts for Bud Powell. And normally the song is done in a up-tempo, jovial kind of way, but after learning about this story, I decided to give it a different treatment. This is my favorite song on the record. This is In Walk Bud, and this will feature Manuel Vallera.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was In Walk Bud featuring Manuel Vallera. Thank you. Since Manuel played his butt off on that one, Chad sent me an email last night. He was like, you know what? I want to feature too, because I want to play my butt off. So this next tune is going to feature Chad. This is Think of One. Thank you.